Khumba is about a zebra who is born with only half his stripes, so he goes on an adventure to get the rest. He also meets way too many characters in a place that's not supposed to have any water because zebras are a bunch of jerks. It begins with a mantis looking at a stick fence that protects a water hole.
This is the only water hole for miles and miles, and it's all ours. Yep, zebras only.
Wait, the zebras built a fence to keep every other species away from the only water hole for miles in this desert? That makes them sound like assholes. Anyway, there's some weird soccer scene, and then Khumba is born under Pride Rock here to his parents, who are king and queen of the zebras. And they take way too long to reveal that he's only half-striped, as if that's not the entire point of the movie. So everyone's freaking out about it, and the clouds go away. I guess it never rains again, since the only water hole for miles is drying up, but Khumba is too busy competing with his female friend to care. That sounds familiar.
Whether or not it's Kumba's fault, if it doesn't rain soon, we'll have to leave.
I don't know what a half-striped zebra has to do with a drought, but okay. And here's a villain named Pongo, an angry feline who's blind in one eye, because this isn't the Lion King at all. In case you couldn't have guessed, Khumba gets bullied for being different. Oh, and his mom is dying. Kumba's all upset about being bullied for being different, and this mantis, I have no idea why is here, draws something, and Khumba freaks out at his friend. Then these gazelles just show up, although I don't know how they got here if there's no water for miles, wanting water. So dumbass here decides, oh, okay, and lets them in, because there's no way that could go wrong. But since the zebras are a bunch of assholes, they kick them out. Well, Pongo notices with some weird smelling thing and goes after them.
It's Pongo?
Wait, if they all live their entire lives inside this fence, how the hell do they know who Pongo is? It doesn't matter, Khumba goes to talk to his mother and she tells him about how all the zebras used to not have stripes, until one went to some magic water hole and swam in it and it gave him stripes. I guess the other zebras liked his stripes and also swam in the magic water hole to get them. Her story is supposed to be a lesson in it's okay to be different, but Khumba is like, I can go there and get the rest of my stripes, and runs off, because that's completely what his mother was telling him to do. And then she dies. Turns out the mantis drew him a map to the magic waterhole, so dumbass runs off to find it, and immediately runs into a hyena named Skulk. Skulk tells him about some magic cream he has to get Khumba his stripes so he doesn't have to go to the magic waterhole, and Khumba is just like, oh, okay, and goes with him. That evening, they run into, I think, a buffalo and an ostrich named Mama V and Bradley. What a surprise, Skulk's plan was a trap.
He's not food, he's worth a lot of water.
Let's eat him.
Alright, I'm just gonna eat you. Sorry, kid, I did my best.
Okay, that line actually made me laugh. But they fight all the hyenas off, and I guess these knockoff Ice Age characters are gonna go with Khumba. How are there so many animals in an area with no water? After what I can only assume is days, Kumba's dad Seko notices that he's missing, and his friend Tombi is gonna go after him, but Seko goes instead. Oh look, what a surprise, the hyenas are working with the leopard. You know, like the Lion King. And some prophecy about a half-striped zebra is mentioned. Kumba's group stops for the night at a spot that somehow has a fire, and this random song just comes out of nowhere. There's not a single other song in this entire movie. Anyway, meanwhile Pongo and Skulk are tracking them down with Pongo's weird smelling thing, and Seko sees Pongo's tracks but not Kumba's. So he decides Kumba's dead and goes home.
This is a sad day, very sad. But Makulu is right, now it will rain.
What an asshole. After more wandering around, Kumba's group runs into a herd of impalas because there's not enough characters in this area with no water. They have this annoying banter about how they all look the same that goes on for way too long. And then they knock down a fence and thank God they leave. Back at the zebra's waterhole, there's no water, so they argue over whether to stay or leave.
We need to leave.
Why is Kumba's friend telling the leader what to do? Oh hey, Khumba found his magic waterhole. But since we're only halfway through this thing, it doesn't work. Then all these characters show up and holy shit, I'm not remembering all these names. Turns out this is some man-made tourist attraction for people to take pictures of animals. The ostrich and buffalo want to stay, but Khumba wants to leave because it's not the magic water hole, and he's still obsessed about getting his stupid stripes. Then all these people show up to take pictures, and some start shooting tranks at them because I guess they're poachers? I don't know. This part doesn't make any sense. It's supposed to be a reserve. Why are there poachers? Anyway, they're after Khumba for some reason and capture him.
No!
I'll take him.
This boy's all I have left.
She just met him like yesterday. But then the bunny smashes the windshield and saves him. I literally don't know what the point of this scene was. I guess it was to get the buffalo and ostrich to leave because they go with Khumba after the rabbit tells him that some black eagle knows where the magic water hole is. Because there's one thing this movie needs, it's more characters. Well, Pongo found their camp like a day late and uses his weird smelling thing to continue tracking them. So Kumba's gang goes to find the goddamn eagle, but first they run into whatever these things are supposed to be, who do some annoying chant for 2 freaking minutes. What is the point of this? This movie is giving me a headache. Back at the zebra hole, I think Kumba's dad, I don't know, half of them look the same, and his friend decide it's time to leave. Back at, I don't care. The black eagle that's white acts like a dick and then shows Khumba where the magic water hole is. But it's actually
Pongo's cave.
Gee, who could have guessed that? Probably anyone who's ever seen a movie before. He then reveals that Pongo was born blind in one eye, and the rest of his leap were a bunch of dicks about it. But it also gave him the strongest sense of smell ever, and he used it to kill them all. Good God, this is a kid's movie. Anyway, after meeting Khumba once, for 5 minutes, all the animals at the animal reserve decide to leave to follow him to this stupid waterhole. Why the hell do they do this? That makes no sense at all. Whatever, the Khumba gang decides to stop at a farm that is randomly there for the night. And because this movie needs even more characters, a crazy sheep comes out and chases them away. After they lock her in a pen, Khumba finally tells the buffalo and the ostrich that the magic water hole is in Pongo's cave, and I guess Pongo ate the buffalo's calf or something. So her and the ostrich decide not to go with him anymore, even though I thought he was like the most important thing to her. So now he's alone. Oh no, what if they never come back? Well, good thing they separated because Pongo finally finds the buffalo and the ostrich and asks him where Khumba is.
You mean Khumba? Oh, that's weird. He's heading to you. Whoop.
Good job, moron. Oh no, Khumba died. But then this old gazelle from earlier comes out of nowhere and brings him a radish for some reason. Somewhere else, the other zebras are wandering around and just so happen to run into the reserve animals, who randomly tell them that they're following Khumba, even though I don't know how they know where to go. So Kumba's dad finds out that he's still alive. Kumba's almost at the cave, but then a tree gets struck by lightning and catches fire. But he just jumps through it, so I don't know what the point of that was. Khumba finally gets to the cave along with every other character, but good thing there's fires in the way so no one else can get inside the cave. And his friend is worried about him.
He'll be okay, Tombi.
Yeah, he's tougher than he looks.
These guys were assholes to him the entire movie. Inside the cave, Kumba's about to go into the water, but then almost gets what his mother is trying to teach him, but Pongo shows up and tells him some prophecy.
It was foretold that a half-striped zebra would be born, and made one of us the most powerful leopard that ever lived.
That doesn't even sound like a real prophecy. It just sounds like something he made up to justify killing his entire leap. Then he says eating Kumba's half will complete his half, because I guess being born half blind is the same thing as being born half striped, even though it's not. They fall in the water and Pongo's about to kill Khumba, but then he remembers about the time he got kicked into a pond, freaks out, and lets him go. And Khumba doesn't get his stripes, so rip off. Eventually their fight breaks to the outside.
Oh no, Khumba!
You guys are assholes to him. Ah, screw it. Pongo scratches Kumba's ass and falls to his death.
He could have survived. No. He's dead.
What the hell was that for? Oh look, Khumba got his stripes after all, because I guess scars count as stripes. And everyone decides to live in this new waterhole together. At least until the zebras kick everyone else out and build a fence around it. Watching this movie is like walking through sludge. It's not a complicated story, but it's just such a slow movie. It's not even an hour and a half long, but you feel every minute of it. This is supposed to take place in an area that doesn't have any water for miles, but there are like 100 characters that just live there. I don't understand why there needs to be so many characters. Most of them are completely unnecessary and annoying. Like the ostrich, who just complains the whole time and whines about everything. That doesn't sound like me at all. Also, they steal plot points from other movies. Like how in the beginning, it's basically the Lion King with this group of animals of the same species, and then the villain has a mark on his eye. And Mama V and Bradley really do remind me of Diego and Sid from Ice Age. Also, they missed the opportunity to make Khumba and Pongo actual parallels. I can see the logic behind comparing half-blind and half-striped, but it's not the same thing. They should have made Pongo half-spotted, like have the back half of him be spotted, and he thinks that eating Khumba will give him the rest of his spots. I know that sounds really dumb, but it's better than "it will make me see better." Khumba doesn't even learn a lesson. The entire movie, he's obsessed with getting the rest of his stripes, while every nice person around him keeps telling him that it's okay to be different. But he keeps putting them in danger for some stupid magic fountain. Then he gets scars on his back and goes, "oh, that's close enough," and is happy because he got his stripes. The voice acting is subpar in this. Jake Austin is okay as Khumba. He can do a calm voice and sound decent, but when he tries to sound upset or angry, he just doesn't sound believable. Loretta Devine is pretty good as Mama V. She's good at sounding annoyed with Bradley's constant complaining and sounding concerned for Khumba. Liam Neeson is in this. Why is he in this? Did he lose a bet? He sounds like he's suffering the whole time and just wants to get it over with. At least his voice acting is really good. The animation isn't too bad, but it's not great either. The animals don't look creepy and they look like the animals they're supposed to be. But some of them do look a bit off, and a lot of them look the same, and it makes it hard to differentiate between the different characters. They make a joke about it with the Impalas not being able to tell each other apart, but they're not the only ones with this problem. I was also impressed with how good the African music was in this. I guess the lesson here is if there's something about you that's different, try to make it so you're like everyone else and it will just work out. Don't forget to do the YouTube stuff, and thanks for watching.